Everybody, today we will make an application where, just like in the previous we had made a sharing app, similarly what we will do today is we will make a speech to text as well as sharing app. So it's like there is an option to record your voice. If you click a button, it will record your voice and convert your voice to the text, and that text you can share it with other people. So, how to do it, I'll show you in today's video. So, first we will change the structure of our backdrop. So, I'll change the background color. I'll change the title. And the name of my app is Text Speecher. So I have given that name here as the title. Now my structure of the background is ready. Now I'll drag some of the components that I'll be needing for my app. So I'll be needing one share button. Okay, like here I'll be writing share. So for that I'll be needing one button. One button I'll need if I want to clear the text which is written on the text box. Then I'll need one text box. I'll need one label. Then I'll go in the social option. And I will choose a sharing option. And at last, I'll be needing one sound recorder. So it will record my sound. So I'll drag the speech recognizer on the screen. So sharing and speech recognizer are the non-visible components. Now, we will give the structure, means we will arrange the components in a systematic way. So I want the text box in the middle. So I'll go on the screen option and I'll align horizontally as, and vertically also I'll align it as center. I'll drag the button and take one button below. Now I want to create a spacing between my text box and my button. So I'll go on the user interface and drag one more label and place it between the text box and the button. Similarly, I'll do it here. I'll remove the text from the label. Now I'll place this on the top, and the text what I'll keep is, please type your, I'll type your welcome to text speaker. Here you can convert speech to text and share it with others. And I'll increase the height. I'm not taking the label option here. I'll just choose one more button. Now I have arranged all my buttons and text box. Now I'll create the structure for each and every component. So starting with button 3. Button 3 is a button. If you click on that button, it will start recording our voice. So now I'll change the font size to, or if you want to write a text, like if you want to write a text instead of an image, you can simply type, click here to record your voice. So you can either use text or you can insert a symbol of speech so that the person can come to know that he has to press here to record his voice. So I will be putting an image. I'll remove the text and I'll choose an image. So I'll click on upload file and upload asset. And I'll choose my image. So now we have the image. So I'll click on this. Now I'll automatically smaller the size of this image. So I change it to 100 by 100 pixels. Now this is done. Now I'll go for text for button 1, that is button 1. Now this is to clear the text on my text box. So I'll change the font size to 20. Then I'll choose the typeface, that is the styling I want. So I'll choose monospace. I'll choose height as automatic, height and width as automatic. Shape, I'll take it as rounded. Text will be clear. I'll change the background color to black, or I'll take it as white. You can take any color you want. Changing it to black, and I'll take the font as bold. Now for button 2, I'll again upload an image here. So I'll go on the image, and just beside the image I'll click on this upload file option and click on upload asset. Now select your image. So I've selected my image. I'll go here on the image drop down and I'll choose my image. I'll set the height and the width. And I'll remove the text. I'll smaller it. So my structure of the app is completed. If I want, I can also give a background image, but I have taken a simple color scheme. Now let's start with the coding part. So go on the blocks option. whenever you are making app, the important thing is just keep a note of which button or which component stands for what purpose. So it will be easy for you while you are coding it. So button 3 was to record my speech. So I'll give the function of button 3 that when button 3 is clicked. So I'll go to speech recognizer 1 get text. Now when I click on button 1 is to clear the text. So when button 1 is clicked, I'll go to text box. And I choose this option and insert it. Now instead of background color, I'll take as text. So this basically means that when button 1 is clicked, then set the text inside the text box to, now I'll go on the text option and I'll select. So it means that when I click button 1, that is clear text, it will set the text to my text box as blank. Okay. And this means that when I click button 3, so speech recognizer will start recording my speech. Now I'll take button 1. When I click cursor button 2, I'll go on now. When button 2 is clicked, button 2 is for sharing. So I'll select the fourth option. And the message will be, go to text box and select the second option, this option. And change this to text. So this means that when I click on button 2, that is the sharing button, so it will give the message. Okay, you have to select the medium, and through that medium, when you click on the app through which you want to send the message, then what it will do is it will send the text which is there in the text box. Now we have just given the button 3 a command that when it is clicked, it will start recognizing the speech. But now we want that it should print it on the text box. So I'll go on the text box option and I'll select set text box 1 dot background color 2. Put it inside the button 3 option. I change the background color to text. So this means that set the text inside the text box 1, 2. But what shall be here? So it will be the result which is obtained after recording the voice. So I'll go on the speech recognizer and I'll select the fourth block. So the result of the speech recognizer, whatever the speech recognizer will record, so that should be printed in the text box. That text should be there in the text box. So we have done the coding now. And in the designer option, in the text box, you can choose the width as fill parent. So fill parent basically means to cover the whole area. So it's like 100%. It will cover the whole area. If I click on the height as fill parent, it will cover the whole area. But since the space is occupied by the buttons, it will only take a few part of the application. Now I'll give a hint here as well. Type your text will be first make a change in the blocks option, go to blocks and remove the save text box 1 from button 3. Go to speech recognizer and select the first block. So this means that when the speech recognizer, after getting the text, like after it has already recorded the voice, it will set the text box to speech recognizer 1.result. And now our app is ready. So you can test your app on your mobile phone. So I'll again repeat the steps of how to take this in your mobile phone, how to test the app in your Android device. So you'll be requiring an Android device. iOS doesn't work. So go to test option and click on connect to companion. A QR code gets generated. Now open your Android device and then download an app called Kodular Companion. I write it in the description box. Just download that app from Google Play Store, and that app, when you open that app, there will be two options. One option is to scan the QR code, and the second option is to write the code. So this is the code. This is the 6-digit code which you have to, either you can type the 6-digit code or you can scan the QR code. So after you do that, automatically the app will open in your Android device and you can test your app. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you liked today's video. Please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to click on the bell icon for more such videos.